back. It's been a very, very long sabbatical. And today I am with one of my ultimate girl crushes, Lil Kimble, and we are talking fitness. But before I introduce you to this hot lady, I just would like to clarify that I am by no means a fitness professional. I'm just enthusiastic. But Lil here has a professional opinion on just about everything. So welcome, Lil.
Right, thank you. So like we have said, I'm Lil Kimble. I'm the owner of OCG Athletic, Action Strength and Conditioning Coach. And I'm here to give you your 5 minutes of fitness.
Okay, so we were just discussing what we wanted to share with you, and I just started my,
like fitness journey.
I've been a little bit disciplined. I've started lifting some things that are heavier than I thought that I could. And one of the myths surrounding this, that I always thought that if I lifted heavy weights, I would become bulky. I also thought that if I just carried on doing cardio, I'd get the body of my dreams. So would you like to give me some clarity on that?
Okay, so this is probably one of the biggest misconceptions in the fitness industry, that lifting heavy weights makes you bulky. Firstly, women don't have the hormonal profile to actually justify that happening. And if you look at the women who do look like that, if you look at bodybuilders, they dedicate their life to building muscle. They train in 2 hours a day, they're eating over 3,500 calories, up to 4,000 calories a day, high protein, high carb. Most women you meet are cutting out carbs, they're doing all the things to go against developing muscle. Also, when you lift a heavy weight, it requires a lot of energy to move that weight, so your fat burn increases. And it's something that we like to refer to as your post-oxygen consumption. So the more, the heavier the weight, the more stressful the workout, the more your calorie burn, as soon as you put the weights down, continues, if that makes sense. So if you go into the gym and get on the treadmill and you run for 20 minutes, as soon as you get off the treadmill, you stop burning calories and accelerated rates. Whereby when you go into gym and you lift really heavy weights, your oxygen consumption post-training is higher than what it normally is.
Okay.
So we advocate lifting heavy weights. I'm a powerlifter, I walk around at 50 kgs, three-time world champion. I'm still battling to put on this crazy muscle that women are picking up all the time. Yeah. Bodybuilders, like I said, they're dedicating 2 hours a day to training, they're eating 3,000-4,000 calories, and they are not gaining the kind of weight that women are claiming to do in the 2 hours that they gym a week. So like I said, it all comes down to hormonal profile.
Okay, and the one thing that I wanted to touch on is I love following your Instagram. Your Instagram story is incredibly real, and facts that I've been trying to learn over the years, I sort of absorbed from the way you kind of put it. And the one thing that spoke to me was that you said that you don't put on weight when you have a cheat meal because you eat carbs every day.
Yes.
Can you touch on that?
Okay, so carbs, this is another massive misconception. By removing carbs from your diet, you're actually slowing down your metabolic process. It's a macronutrient that your body requires, and the more you're eating the macros required for your body, the faster your metabolism is going to go. So if you have one or two cheat meals, you go out on the weekend, you have a pizza, your body's just going to metabolize that food because your body's used to it, it's conditioned to those foods. As soon as you remove carbohydrates from your diet, you slow down your metabolic process and you're actually creating a problem. You must eat carbs in order to lose weight.
Oh, okay. And then the next thing I would like to touch on for everybody watching at home, not the fitness freaks. What can, for example, now the kids are back at school, I'm stressed. I don't have time to get into the gym as often as I'd like to. What advice would you have for me to do at home?
Okay, so firstly, you want to do exercises that give you bang for your buck. Okay.
Okay.
If you're going to stand around and do a bicep curl, you're only isolating a certain muscle group. You want something that's going to challenge your whole body.
Yes.
So a jump squat. Something simple and explosive that requires your whole body is going to give you a lot more than an isolated exercise.
Okay, so if I had to do three exercises at home, how many reps and sets do I need to do?
Okay, so the reps and sets are the crucial thing, and that's a blog for another day. But I always recommend staying between 12 and 8 reps, if anything. Obviously, when your form starts to alter, rather drop the weight. Make sure you do everything perfectly.
Okay.
And some really good exercises that are full body movements, something like a push-up, a body weight squat, a jumping lunge, just something like that that's explosive.
Okay, so do you want to just show me quickly what I can do at home? Three things, and
okay.
Everyone can just watch and...
Ladies push-up, so for the non-fitness freak, someone who's only starting to develop strength, you can do these on your knees. Chest to ground, back up. Body weight squat into jump squat, and then switch lunge. So you're going to get into a lunge position, explode.
Okay, well, that's all we have for today. And if you have any fitness questions that you would like clarified, you can pop us an email or on Instagram or DM us, it's fine. The other thing I'd like to say that I learned from you this week was I normally have coffee after my post-workout.
And you've stopped.
And I stopped because I learned from you.
Cover why you shouldn't drink coffee after you drink.
Bye guys, we also need to come up with something to end with. So if anyone has any great ideas, you can post that to us as well.
Cool.
Bye!